Let's take a look at how it happened. These 100 titles over 19 countries, 20 times he's done it without dropping a set. It's just a remarkable run over all kinds of surfaces and generations of opposition. That's the thing to keep in mind. He's had to adjust to different generations, players playing with different technology, different surface speeds and styles, and he's had that amazing ability to just make it look so easy all the time.
You mentioned different surfaces. One of those came on indoor carpet. So Federer is not just outlasting the competition, he's outlasting surfaces. There are no more events played on indoor carpet.
Well, you mentioned the 109 number. So now that he's got triple digits, it's okay, I think, to ask, can he, will he, does he get to 109? That's the most in the open era of Mr. Connors.
I've refused to keep making these because we have no, he keeps breaking the mold, right? He's breaking what should and can happen. You know, at 38 years of age, coming up on that and feeling as healthy as he is, so much of it's about his scheduling, playing a little bit less, but why not? Why not a couple more years with four or five titles each?
I think it's going to be difficult, to be candid. I would bet against it for sure, just because he doesn't play that many tournaments, and the tournaments he plays are only the ones typically with the big fields. So it's not easy. If he wanted to chase that, he could go play some 250s, right, and I think he could sweep it no problem. But that, why would he do that, right? He's all about the big titles. And nothing's going to change at the end of the day if he doesn't get past Jemmy's record.
Well, you know he's going to win Halle and Basel. He wins those every year. So chalk those up. And Wimbledon's a good chance as well. By the way, beating Cioric and Tsitsipas in the last two matches in Dubai, he's now 89-14 lifetime against guys born in the 90s.